Hello, fellow meerkats. I'd like to show you how you can upload my created new meerkat avatar for our entire group. And yes, I will not show how you can change the texture because this is a part you can, I guess, find out for yourself. It wouldn't be that complicated. I will show you only the part where what you have to do to upload your Meerkat character to VRChat. And so let's start Unity. So we can create a new project, or we use an already created one, but I prefer to create a new project file. So click on the triangle. Click on Unity 2018.4.20 F1. Name it to something you like. Unity package. Choose the location and click on create. Now we have the sample scene here. The first thing we have to do in order to get the dynamic bones functional, because I added it already to the Meerkat avatar, is to open the asset store. I hope you have already bought it, the package. Click on My Assets. And click on Import. The package name is Dynamic Bone from Will Hong. Make sure everything is selected and click on import, but usually everything is normally selected. So we need now the SD3, S w wait, SDK3 package for VRChat. VRC SDK3. Oh gosh. Okay. Yes. Double click on it. Everything should be already selected, and click on import. Nice, there it is. So, and so as a last step, we will import the meerkat. Double click on the meerkat Unity package. It will import some faces, face animations, two materials. The mesh itself is a blend file, so you can open it easily with Blender. There are two texture files, one for the eyes and the body texture itself. There is a scene file and a texture file. Text file. Oh gosh. I'm sorry. Text file. There are only very few rules in the text file. You can read it for yourself. Double click on the meerkat scene. Double click on the meerkat first iteration done. Here is a meerkat. So it should be already ready for upload. So there shouldn't be a blueprint ID. The view position should be near the nose. That's my preferred point of view, but you can change it, of course, if you like. Lip sync should be already set up. You can change the general eye look if you want. The eye rotations should be fine. Eyelids with R blinking should be already set up with blend shapes. And I have already added the facial expressions. So, yes, you can smile on something like that. Here are the dynamic bone scripts. Make sure the colliders are set. The only dynamic bone script that doesn't have any collider in the collider array is a tail, because you can't reach your tail normally. You can't reach your tail. Yes. Okay. So I will show you where the texture is. You can change. It is in the folder, in the project window, in the folder models and textures. And there is a meerkat fur texture. I know it looks really messed up, because in my first texture iteration I had done a big mistake and I didn't clean it up. I only overpainted it. again, so that's why it looks like this. Yeah, I'm sorry for that. I'm not a professional CGI artist. I work with Blender around about 10 years only in my free time, so my UVs aren't that professional. Okay, but of course you can change the UV in Blender or other programs if you like. I know there is a better way to do this than my way I had gone. Yeah, okay. I show you, okay, I show you the little way to change the texture. Double. I hope you have Blender installed. So double click in Unity on the blend file. It will open up Blender with these views. I added a little text file and as you can see there is a, what was it named again, the image editor and the UV editor. You use the image editor to reskin the avatar. So you click in the object mode on your tabulator key on the keyboard. Press A . Okay, interesting, why can't I see? Oh yeah, you have to change from view to paint mode, so now you can see the meshes. So you can paint in this little window here directly. There should be where is it again? Interesting. My color palette is gone. Okay. So I guess you will own your, you will choose your own colors then. You can paint in this here while you are in the edit mode on the right side, or you can go to texture paint. And now you can draw on the mesh. I will make only a little, whoopsie, only a little, yes, I will draw a heart on the chest. Oh, I see the symmetrize mode is on. You can Isn't on. Oh, I know. Oh gosh, yes. Yes, oh gosh, I forgot. The UVs are on top of each other for the left and for the right side. So if you draw on one side, it will automatically appear on the other side of the character. Okay. You can change that easily. There are enough tutorials on YouTube, I guess. So I will only draw this little heart. Okay, so when you're done with drawing, go back to the object modes, and here comes the important step. You'll see a little star beneath the image text. Click on image and click on save. When you close Blender and you doesn't save the image file, your work is lost. Okay, it changed me. No, it has saved it to a wrong folder for me. So click on Save As, go into the Unity project folder. Assets, models, textures. Override Sphere. Takes a few seconds, and yes, a little heart will appear. Okay. So second, there is a really small gap in the center of the heart. There. Go into paint mode. And draw it a tiny bit over the edge of the mesh so the gap will disappear then. Again. Save as. Nice, the gap is gone. Cool. So the only thing you have to do now is click on VRChat SDK, click on Show Control Panel, looks like this. Enter your username and password. I will do it really quickly, but not in the video, so you can see my credentials. Now I have deleted the already uploaded version. If the window in the builder shows you something, some buttons with autofix, click on them. And when it's done, click on Build and Publish for Windows. Name your avatar. Make sure you upload your own avatar as private. We're here, and here's the character. And here we are. Nice. Facial expressions are working. My dynamic bones are working. Nice. So I hope this video helps you in one way or another. If you have questions, feel free to ask me in the Telegram group, the Meerkat group, and yeah, have fun. Bye.